I guess some players might be, you know, having a nightmare time with the pressure, not being able to cope. Some players obviously are, I think, just trying to relax. But I think for any player, these are the kind of matches where any player would want to be playing. And not just playing, but shine. And any player, whoever has to succeed in football, big matches are the most important thing for them. And that's where the nerve and your character comes out. And if you can succeed and play well and, you know, do well in these big matches, then I think you have capacity to cope up with any other matches. So players go under huge pressure, but I think being positive, thinking positive is what they require. And as a player, I always was excited for these big matches despite having a huge pressure on me as well.
It's something that I think is going to happen anywhere, not only at derby, but I think any game, that excitement is there. And it's up to the player, you know, to try to control that. I think everyone has their own way to hold, you know, that excitement and to turn into a focus. That is very important. I think everyone has their own way. I was saying that people like to sleep in early, some people like to sleep in late, some people like to listen to music. So everyone has a way of, you know, to deal with that excitement, with that pressure.
I think my all-time favorite striker, it's not one but two, of when I played for India. One is Ayan Bijain, because when I was just young boy getting to the national team, he was the senior player and we really combined well. And then later on, my best footballing career and tenure or years of football was towards the end with Sunil Chhetri. So I think these two players have been fantastic in terms of having great combination as strike partner.
I always praise him Baitun. It was, I think we had real, he was a really good partner, very good understand, you know, between us. It was eye contact and we already understand each other. I always know where he wants the ball, what was the best way for him to score that goal, and he just making sure that he had to be there. We all understand both of, you know, parts of each other, and it's always helping with our communication, and it was really, I think, one of the best what I work with.
Yeah, I think the favorite moments are you coming in a bus to the stadium, and on the way you see red and gold or green and maroon, you know, trucks of people getting to the stadium shouting their club slogans and songs, singing the club songs. I think these are the moments where it really gets you excited. So yeah, getting to those big matches and getting to the stadium.
There's two games which are still very fresh in my memory. One was when Joseph Blatter came to Kolkata, very prestigious derby. And I just want to make sure that, yeah, this derby is, we are going to win that. And fortunately, we won that game. I scored one of the goals. The other one was the 5-3. We won against West Bengal, where it was really important for the supporters. And where till today, they are sharing with that victory against West Bengal.
Surprising this season, I think Hawaz has gone for 3 defense and 5 midfield. And which is okay. I think Hawaz is someone who wants to keep defensively very, very compact. He likes soaking up the pressure, and his team always play great in counter attack. But having, you know, 5 midfield, it's about stretching the other opponent, so which is also quite good. But I think we need to give him time. He's always done 4-2-3-1 has been is the formation which he succeeded in the past, and 3-5-1 is something which we will have to see. So it all also depends on the kind of players he has. Before, when he won the ISL, I think he had that quality players to hold on to the defensive midfield. So 4-2-3-1 was a great formation.
I just feel with Hawaz is really, he played defensively but thinking offensively. So is give a bit of priority on defending to defending strongly, and just getting the opportunities when the opponent is really very high in their ground, in our own ground, in the ground of ETK Bagan. So they are moving to counters, and they're having the players for that. And Habas been playing in this style for, I think, the last seasons. And I think when I look into the results of the last, he won 3 ICLs during this time. So it's been working out. So I don't think should change anything that's been working.
My first answer is to Sandeep Sahak. The deciding factor for this match, obviously, for SC East Bengal is to play more defensively, because they're playing first match. It's a completely new team. Try not open up and play free-flowing football to give ATK Mohunbagan a lot of space and opportunity for them to attack. So I think slowly, as the match progresses, once the team starts getting their combination right and the confidence, I think they can start being more creative. But I think it's a very cautious approach is what SC East Bengal will have to take in this match against ATK Mohunbagan.
Hi, Subhajit Mandol. It's a very good question of yours. The question is this a new era of the Kolkata Derby? And in my point of view, and I say yes, it's a new venture for both of the clubs, a new venture for the Derby. And it's just a kind of joining ICL this season. It's just a kind of dressing up a new dress, where it's going to look in where it's going to look interesting and beautiful, and of course it's going to bring in a worldwide exposure for the clubs, for the Derby, and of course for the league also.
Second question is from East Bengal Fans Club. The most memorable goal for me would definitely be the Federation Cup semi-final, but the final goal, third goal, I think, in fact, I wanted to pass that ball to my teammate and he was in a better position, but somehow it came back to me as a gift, and that was my hat-trick goal as well. So it was just given in a platter, and when I scored, I felt blessed and I felt, I could smile and laugh all the way, because that goal, it might not be very fancy or great, but it was the most important goal for me. And when you wanted to do something good for the team, sometimes you get rewarded yourself. So I was very, very lucky with that goal. So third goal of East Bengal, which was my hat-trick goal, is the most memorable one.
What makes ATK Mohunbagan different from all other clubs? And how does it feel like representing the green and maroon jersey? I think the history of these two clubs are huge. It's the history behind of these two clubs is something that making them big. And I feel as a player, I think every player one day dream to play for one of these clubs. And unfortunately, I had that opportunity to join Mohunbagan and build it up a very beautiful story over there. And of course, it was always a proud moment for me to represent in this club. Wherever, when I'm talking about the club, wherever where I'm going to play, is of course is. It was always a proud moment for me.
I think as a player, you don't want to ask anything more than that, because you're playing in front of 140,000, which is the highest crowd ever, even in world football as well, to come and witness the match. And in front of that kind of supporter, to score first ever derby hat-trick is something which any player across the world would dream of. So for me, I think it was something which, till today after retirement, people talk about that match, and I still am recognized with that match. So it was a great feeling.
I think this name came with the time, and I think the supporters, they want me to be associated with something what they love, what they believe that it was something special. And I was really privileged to get in the name of Green Paratá. I got in Sabustotá, and that's a name that always supporters using to shout and, you know, and during the training, the sessions, during the games. And of course, it's when you get a call and a shout with this name, definitely it's bring you a joy, and definitely is a point to motivate you also to moving forward, to getting motivated, and yeah, in the end of the day, performing very well into the ground. I had, of course, been playing for a club for more than 12 years. There is a lot of things that happened during this time. I had really great moments where I still very fresh in my mind, but derby is always going to be special. You know, the goals is calling the derbies that you won, and always will be the really special one for me. And another one is, I think in my birthdays, during my birthdays, where the supporters, they using to find me anywhere in the city, and just to wish me a happy birthday, bringing cakes, flowers, banners. It was something that I really appreciate, and always I love. I think this relationship with the supporters of Mohamedan. I feel everyone that is on the pitch, on the ground, in action. I think you are definitely you having the opportunity and the chance to do whatever you want, you know. And he's an excellent player. I think he's already proving himself during the last season, and started very well in this season. And I feel he has all the potential, all the capabilities to really become a great player, and also to be another loved one by the supporters of ATK Mohamedan.